Bienvenidos a Zona Kite, el primer programa de TV dedicado al universo del kitesurf. En Kite en primera persona, Lewis Crowder nos cuenta su poderosa historia de fascinación por el viento y cómo podemos lograr combatir el cambio climático. En Kite Calendar, nos vamos a Italia para el Sardinia Grand Slam ICA. En Viajando con el Viento, continuamos viendo la segunda parte del road trip del equipo de F1 a través de Baja California. En Kite School aprendemos cómo hacer un primer vuelo en una tabla de foil con la Duotone Academy. En el clip del día, cerramos el programa con un recap de lo que fueron los Cold Hawaii Games. Llegó la hora de entrar en la zona donde volar es posible. Esto es Zona Kite. El cambio climático es un hecho innegable que nos demanda un compromiso de parte de todos. Hoy conocemos la historia del rider británico Lewis Crowder, su relación con el viento, su objetivo de contarle al mundo sobre su potencial y cómo tiene un papel vital en la lucha contra el cambio climático.
When you look back, what do you see? I see a connection between my family and the ocean.
Hey, get the white boys. Oi.
I can see just how much we have changed. My life revolves around the wind. I notice it every day, and I'm fascinated by its sheer power. The wind has shaped my career. And I have learned how to harness its power to my full potential. I'm Lewis Crowder, 4 times British champion and 8 times Red Bull King of the Air competitor. There is a connection between my passion and wind energy, and together with GWEC, I am on a journey to make a difference.
Everybody connects with a windy day or that there's wind, and I love the symbol and the symmetry of a wind turbine.
We are in a climate emergency, and we all must make changes in order to achieve the goal of net zero.
We've now got 10 years to fix this. So through my lifetime, I guess the urgency has increased and increased.
The only way we're going to do this is by using clean, renewable energy.
Wind energy for me, you know, is part of the solution. It's part of, you know, making the world a better place where, you know, our kids can survive and thrive.
We believe we all have a responsibility to teach the next generation. Kitesurfing is an incredible tool to engage people with. With a kite, you can pass the power of the wind into anyone's hand and teach them how to control it. I see a better future for all of us, working with nature and not against it. We have the solution, the wind.
Llega una nueva edición de los Kitefold World Series Cagliari 2021, organizado por la International Kitesurf Association. Con sede en Sardinia, Italia, participaron del evento riders de distintas partes del mundo, destacando la presencia de los representantes argentinos. En mujeres, Catalina Turienzo de Montehermoso, con 15 años de edad, es miembro del equipo olímpico juvenil argentino. Y en hombres, Federico Aguilar, del Club Náutico Paraná. Estas son las primeras competencias para ambos después de 2 años sin poder asistir a ningún campeonato nacional e internacional debido a la pandemia.
Piso de los deportes, el turismo esportivo. Yo represento el turismo. El mio collega presidente del CUNI, lo sport. Insieme per vincere e portare la Sardegna nel mondo.
Sport e turismo credo che siano due cose che devono camminare insieme. Sono la forza di quest'isola. Noi abbiamo veramente tutto per poter competere ai livelli internazionali e grazie all'assessorato del turismo, che è molto sensibile, noi speriamo che lo sport possa continuare a crescere.
Hello everyone, I'm Maxime Azela and I'm the winner of the Kitefall World Series in 2017 and 2019. I'm super happy to be here for my fourth time. I'm still enjoying the Puerto Beach, which is for me a pretty good place because I have really good memories here. So I'm here for competing for the 2021 Kitefall World Series and I hope I will keep the title with me here.
First, I am happy of being here and I am excited, a little bit nervous, anxious, but very, very excited race today with the experienced riders. I am going to see what happens and try to have a good time.
We've come all the way from New Zealand, which is on the other side of the world, and I'm really excited to see how the rest of the women's fleet are going, and I'm looking forward to some tough racing over the next few days.
Today we had 5 races in really challenging condition because the wind was really strong and really gusty, so it was really hard to race in those conditions. My just goal was to finish the race without crashing and without hurting myself, so I'm happy.
Mauritius is an awesome place to kite surf. Unfortunately, the kite foiling scene, especially the racing, is pretty small on the island. We only have a few kite foilers around, so it's hard to get good challenge and good competition. That's why I travel all the way to Europe, Sardinia, where I can come and challenge myself and see where the level is at in Europe and get some good racing and proper training in. Yesterday we had an awesome day in nuking conditions. It was pretty rough out there and I'm really looking forward to today. It will be a bit more chilled with a better breeze.
I'm Wojtakowska, I'm 16 years old. This is my first year of Formula Kite. This is my third competition. Riders are very on the top level. I'm happy to compete with them. I'm very excited and looking forward to improve more.
I feel super good. Like to be first is always really good, I think, and I feel really ready for the World Championship. And yeah, it's just so nice to finish first. I had a really, really tough competition the first day, and after it was pretty okay. But like, I really like to fight with Poema.
I'm really happy for my result, 6 overall and first under 19, and now I'm the race with the other guys is really difficult, hard level, and now I'm ready, stay focused for next week in the World Champion.
This is the end of the third stop here in Cagliari of the Kite for World Series. It was really tough competition. We got super nice wind every day, and I'm super happy about this win. I will be even more confident for the next week for the World Championship.
Viajando con el viento, seguimos viendo los 7 en baja, el corto dirigido por Olivier Sautet y protagonizado por el equipo de F1 durante su road trip a través de Baja California.
This was a dreamy session, but this came at a price. We now have three men down. A little break was needed. And after some uno, tacos, uno again, breakfast, fish taco, cartoon, uno, and a few nice tisane, we were back on the search. But this time to find a flat spot. It's hard to describe such a landscape, and it was surrealistic to see it scroll by at full speed. Nothing behind me, everything ahead of me, as is ever so on the road. Romeo Barras wrote this sentence from Jack Kerouac never felt so real and understandable. We can't wait to see what adventure lies ahead.
El primer vuelo controlado con la tabla de foil es un cambio de juego. La sensación que vas a sentir te va a cambiar para siempre la forma en que ves el kitesurf. Una vez que salís del agua y te parás en la tabla, recordá empujar con tu cadera y colocar tu peso para adelante hacia tu pie delantero. Cuando ganes velocidad, mantén tu rodilla delantera doblada y lista para flexionarla en todo momento. Realiza esto para mantener el eje central de tu cuerpo en posición vertical. Volá el kite a 45 grados e incrementá la velocidad continuamente. Cuando la tabla esté aumentando la velocidad, empezá a orzar despacio upwind hasta que las líneas y la tabla estén a un ángulo de 90 grados. Esto facilitará mantener la tabla volando. Por otro lado, tus pies no tienen que empujar la parte trasera de la tabla hacia el agua. En cambio, mantén tu rodilla delantera flexionada y tu cuerpo vertical con el peso en tu pierna delantera, levantando tu pie delantero dentro del strap. Esto va a ayudar a sacar la tabla fuera del agua y sobre el foil. Una vez que la tabla está en el aire, el peso sobre tu pie delantero te va a ayudar a estabilizar tu vuelo. Cuando sientas la tabla elevándose del agua, flexiona tu rodilla delantera aún más para mantener tu cuerpo vertical y el peso adelante. Una vez que la tabla está en el aire, el peso sobre tu pie delantero te va a ayudar a estabilizar tu vuelo. Repitamos los elementos clave. Dobla tu pierna delantera y mantén tu peso hacia adelante. Permanece con tu cuerpo en posición vertical sin inclinarte hacia tu pie trasero. Flexiona tu rodilla delantera aún más si sentís el foil elevándose. Disfruta de tu aventura con Duotone Kiteboarding Academy. Los Code Hawaii Bigger tuvieron lugar desde el 10 al 26 de septiembre y se llevaron a cabo entre Bora Port y Hanstholm, en Dinamarca. 18 de los mejores y más locos kitesurfistas del mundo compitieron en la segunda edición de este increíble evento, en donde se pudieron ver trucos increíbles. Zona Kite es tu zona. Vos también sos protagonista de nuestro programa. Suscríbete a nuestro canal de YouTube y entérate de todo lo que pasa en el mundo del kitesurf. Los esperamos en la próxima edición de Zona Kite.